Let's finish up the review problems with the coefficient of friction with numbers 9 and 10. Number 9, the block below, is being pushed down the ramp as pictured. As a result of the push, the block is moving down the ramp at a constant speed. We're going to find the coefficient of friction between the block and the ramp, given that we know our pushing force is 25 newtons. So the force is acting on the block. We have the normal force up. We have gravity perpendicular down. Friction goes to the left. Our force of push goes to the right. And gravity parallel goes to the right. We were given the force of push is 25 newtons and the acceleration is zero. We're trying to find that coefficient. We're going to find the normal force because in order to find the coefficient, we only have one equation with the coefficient of friction in it. And it's the friction force equals the coefficient times the normal force. So we better have both the friction and the normal force in order to solve for our coefficient. So let's get the normal force first. Normal's up, force of gravity perpendicular is down. They're equal to each other because it is not accelerating in the y direction. So that gives me gravity perpendicular is the cosine of 30 degrees times the mass, which is 8 kilograms, times g, which is 9.8 meters per second squared. That tells me that the normal force is 67.9 newtons. Now we're going to add up our forces that go to the right and the forces that go to the left. Forces that go to the right are positive, so force of pull and gravity parallel are positive forces. Force of friction goes to the left, so that is a negative force, and that's going to equal ma, but remember a is zero, so m times a is zero, so it all is just zero on the right side. That just tells me that my right stuff, gravity parallel and the force of pull, equals my left stuff, which is friction. That equation is going to remain unchanged, except that I plugged in what friction is, which is the coefficient times the normal force. We're trying to solve for this coefficient, so I'm just going to divide the normal force over to the left. That's why it's now in the denominator, and I can plug in my numbers and solve. Force of gravity parallel, we have an equation for that. It's the sine of 30 degrees times the mass, which is 8 kilograms, times g, which is 9.8 meters per second squared. Force of push was given in the problem at 25 newtons, and we solve for the normal force, 67.9 newtons. Plugging that into my calculator, I get a coefficient of 0.95. for my answer. Let's take a look at number 10. Number 10, a 74-kilogram stuntman is being dragged at a constant speed, again, very important, constant speed, on the ground via a rope that is attached to a running horse. The tension in the rope is 385 newtons. We want to know what the coefficient between the stuntman and the ground happens to be. So we got to make sure we get our picture drawn. Here's my little man. Here's the rope going to the right. That's tension. Friction goes to the left. Normal goes up. Gravity goes down. Acceleration is zero because he's moving at a constant speed. Mass is 74 kilograms. The tension is 385 newtons. We're trying to find the coefficient. Normal is going to equal gravity because it's not accelerating up and down. It's not accelerating in any direction. And the force of gravity is mass, 74 kilograms, times g, 9.8 meters per second squared. And that gives me a normal force of 725.2 newtons. Now I'm going to go to my left and right because I'm trying to find out what the coefficient of friction is, so I need the actual force of friction. So the tension to the right is positive minus friction to the left, that's why it's negative here, equals ma, but remember a is zero, so it's just zero over here. M times zero is nothing. So that means that my tension is going to equal force of friction when I add friction over here to the other side, and I know the friction is the coefficient times the normal force. Because that's just what the friction is. I can solve for the coefficient by dividing the normal force to the other side, and that gives me tension divided by the normal equals mu. Tension is 385 newtons, the normal force is 725.2 newtons, and all of that, when I plug it in my calculator, gives me a coefficient of 0.53 for my answer. So that finishes up the answers to the forces problems with the coefficient of friction. If you have any questions, shoot me an email.